Hi, I'm Lori McLaughlin, Senior Editor Digital at MIT Sloan Management Review. And we're here at the MIT CIO Symposium, where top IT and business leaders share lessons learned and look ahead at upcoming challenges. It's a gathering of true business innovators. This year, attendees are exploring the hardest aspects of handling AI, especially generative AI. So we asked conference speakers and CIO Leadership Award finalists to share their key advice with you.
I think business leaders have the same blind spot as just about everyone about GenAI at the moment. And that is the text that we see generated by GenAI is so good and so coherent compared to questions that we ask that it looks like the system must be able to reason. But in fact, they can't reason. They are finding the best words that fit together with the question, but they can't make logical inference. And we shouldn't forget that because it can lead to very bad results.
To actually use GenAI for real enterprise applications, we need to be able to bring in our knowledge, our people context, our unstructured content all together so that we can then have the appropriate mechanism to interact with GenAI LLM. Getting that information curated and put together is a significant blind spot for most organizations.
One of the blind spots that we have in generative AI is around data governance. And we often talk around data governance around how good is the data that it's being trained on. But I would ask leaders to think not just about how good is the data, but whose data is there and which data is there. And I think we have to think carefully about over-representations and under-representations and what they may yield in terms of outcomes for an LLM. So what I'm really thinking about here when I say data governance is making sure that we do so responsibly and make sure that our LLMs are not amplifying anything that has bias or creating new hallucinations or outcomes that are unintended.
There's a lot of push to do things with GenAI, but there's also a lot of push to be careful and manage the risk in there. And there's a lot of activity, but it's pretty incremental stuff. It's chats, it's document summarization. What we're missing now is the truly fundamental change that's going to be possible when we make GenAI work. Transforming the entire claims process, the entire underwriting process for loans, product design process, all of these. This is the blind spot right now. There's a push to do something, but not that big push to truly transform processes in the way that it can be happening. And I expect that to happen in the next year or so where that takes off.
I would say that a big blind spot that business leaders have about GenAI right now is that they have a fairly minimal understanding of how it actually works. And you know, you'd say, okay, it doesn't really matter, but it really, really, really does. Because as you think about it, as technology grows more and more complex, the average business leader level of understanding just keeps coming down and down and down and down. And when you get a technology like GenAI that insidiously integrates into workflows, right? It's not a big banging technology in certain ways. It just kind of comes in quietly. That, combined with a lack of understanding on the part of senior management, real kind of recipe for disaster.
One of the blind spots that a lot of leaders have when it comes to generative AI is actually the language that we speak and the way in which we know how to ask questions. The greatest value that can come from generative AI in the long term is how do we ask questions that we don't know how to ask? How do we talk to a computer to solve a problem that we've never tried to explain to someone else before? So rather than asking ourselves the question, how do I implement this particular piece of technology to answer the question, say, what's the most efficient route to get from point A to point B? How do we teach ourselves to say, what are the limitations to shipping something from point A to point B? Asking questions in the inverse to figure out what are those insights about that question, about that problem we're trying to solve, that the AI just won't give us naturally. Really push your teams to ask for the insights behind the answer, not just the answer that the model pumps out itself.
So one blind spot that leaders have about GenAI right now is the security aspect of using GenAI. We're all excited about the capabilities that it brings to our organizations, but what we forget about is the risks that we're taking when we use GenAI. Sometimes the information you put into a GenAI system ends up in the public. Sometimes the answers we get from GenAI are not real. They're hallucinations. How do we make sure that the information is actually valid? And maybe more important is the issue of our dependence on the answers without really validating that they're really good answers. Do we want our people using GenAI to answer a question without really thinking about if the answer is useful or not?